Shalom Gabriel, nice to see you again this evening. How are you?
Shalom Dad, nice to see you too. I'm great today. And you?
So am I. I'm a great. Gabriel, what are we gonna do this evening?
We're gonna read the Bible.
All right. I think that's very good. Okay. But before you read the Bible, I think it should be better if you pray first, please.
Yeah, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we're gonna hear to your word. Please bless me and ask. Please, Holy Spirit, please ask about your word so that we can be the doer of your word. In Jesus' name, we pray, hallelujah, amen.
Amen. Thank you very much for your prayer, Gabriel. What is the topic this evening that you gonna share?
Abraham's faith confirmed.
All right. I think it's very interesting topic, Gabriel. Please take the time.
Thank you. Shalom Church, how are you today? I hope you're great today, amen. Now let's open our Bible from Genesis 22 verse 1 until verse 19. Abraham's faith confirmed. But now I just read verse 1 until verse 5. In the rest you can read by yourself. Verse 1. Now it came to pass, after these things, that God tested Abraham and said to him, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. Verse 2. Then he said, Take now your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as your burnt offering on one of the mountains of which I shall tell you. Verse 3. So Abraham rose early in the morning and saddled his donkey and took two of his young men with him and Isaac his son. And he split the wood for the burnt offering and arose and went to the place of which God had told him. Verse 4. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted his eyes and saw the place of above. Verse 5. And Abraham said to his young men, Stay here with the donkey, and I will go yonder and worship, and we will come back to you. Amen. Now I'm going to explain verse 20. Chapter 22. So, in one day, God tested Abraham and said, Abraham, and Abraham said, Here I am, my Lord. And God said to Abraham, Took now your son, your only son that you love, for birth of a ring in the land of Moriah, and in the land of Moriah, on the mountain that I shall tell you. Then Abraham rose early in the morning and took two of his young men and saddled his donkey. And he took Isaac his son. And on the third day, Abraham saw the place of Barak. Then they went to the land of Moriah, and on the mountain that God had told Abraham. On the mountain, Abraham said to his two young men, Stay here with the donkey. I will go to the mountain with Isaac to worship Lord. Then Abraham took the wood for burnt offering, the knife, the fire, and others. Then Isaac said to his father Abraham, and saying to him, "My dad." And Abraham said, "Here I am, my son." And Isaac said, "Where is the lamb for burnt offering?" And Abraham said, "God will provide the lamb for burnt offering." Then on the mountain, Abraham saddled his son Isaac, and let's open our Bible from Genesis 22, verse 9 until verse 10. I'm gonna read for you. Verse 9. Then they came to the place of which God had told him, and Abraham built an altar there and placed the wood and on in order. And he bound Isaac, his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. Verse 10. And Abraham stretched out his hand and took the knife to slay his son. Before Abraham slay his son, the angels of God said to Abraham, saying to him, "Abraham, Abraham." And Abraham said, "Here I am, my Lord." And the angels of God said to Abraham, "Don't touch your son, your only son, because I shall establish my covenant with him." Then Abraham looked around and he saw a lamb. And Abraham asked Isaac to take the lamb. So then they went down and they met Abraham's young man. Then the angels of God said to Abraham, and it's written in verse in Genesis 22, verse 16 until verse 18. Let's read. I'm gonna read for you. Verse 16. And said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done these things, and have not withheld your son, your only son." And verse 17. "Blessing I will bless you, and multiplying I will multiply your descendants as the stars of the heaven and as the sand of the earth. And your descendants shall possess the gate of their enemies." After that, Abraham went to the land to Beersheba. And Abraham lived in Beersheba. Amen. Now let's pray. Heavenly Father, I have finished your word. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that teach us about your word. And now we know about your word. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Dad.
Amen. Interesting story. Nice sharing, Gabriel. But I have a question for you before we wrap up our meeting this evening. Question number one, why did God ask Abraham to take his son Isaac for the sacrifice as burnt offering?
Yeah, because God tested Abraham, and it's written in Genesis 22, verse 1. "Now it came to pass after this thing that God tested Abraham, and said to him, 'Abraham,' and he said, 'Here I am.'" Verse 2. "Then he said, 'Take now your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains of which I shall tell you.'"
Did Abraham obey God's word?
Yes, Abraham obeyed God's word.
Did Abraham kill Isaac?
No, before Abraham killed Isaac, the angels of God said to Abraham, saying to him, "Abraham, Abraham, don't kill your son, your only son, whom you love, because I know that you trust in God.
Did God provide the lamb for burnt offering?
Yes, God provided the burnt offering for Abraham and Isaac.
All right. Thank you so much, Gabriel. I think it's very, very interesting story of Abraham. And I hope it will inspire the teenagers like you who watch this program. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye.
God bless you too. Bye.